Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? Up in field 5, you can see him there, he's moving back and forth. The hired help is carrying on doing the planting up there. I set him off again. He'd just sort of run out of space at the angle that he was moving at. I finished all the fertilizer spreading. The Deutz with the Amazon fertilizer spinner, that is now parked up in the corner of field 33, next to where we got the tank. He's under the shelter in there. And we have here the Krone Ultima baler. We loaded it up last time, all ready to go, and we are going to try it out here in this field doing some baling. First of all, the week's question. And you just go through here. The week's question. I am going to buy a wheel loader to use over at the biogas plant. Do you want me to buy a Liebherr? Do you want me to buy a JCB? Or, let me move through here, do you want me to buy the new Holland? The cat is not an option. I don't want to get that one. That is more of a industrial machine rather than agricultural. It's not suitable. So it's this one here. This is the one that I'm thinking of. Or the Liebherr or the JCB. It's your vote. It's your game. Head down below. Let me know what you want. Now then, let's get started with this baler. You know what? I'm going to do this out of cab to start with so that we can admire this beast. Because it is just awesome. First of all, I'll start the tractor up. There we go. And we will just have to walk around the outside of the baler once we're in the field, double check that everything is okay. I have actually turned the traffic off, incidentally, and it has, especially when I'm on the road or I'm in the main yard where we got all the chickens, it's given me nearly an extra 10 frames a second, which is a huge difference, so I will be leaving the traffic off on this map. I know that it's not ideal, and it would be better if we could have the traffic on the map, but I feel it's better to make that small sacrifice rather than having bad frame rates. Now then, if we... and just bring up the help there. So we can unfold the drop mat. That goes on the back. Although we're not actually going to be using the wrapper this time. Is there any other options? We can open the side doors. We don't need to worry about that. There's no options there. Come round this side. Any options? Right, there's no options there. Okay, let's climb in and we'll see what we got. We got baler, enable IC. That's for the tractor. Activate work camera. Yeah, that also does the tractor. So, yeah. That's a bit awkward, because activating the work camera also switches the tractor on and off, so we won't worry too much about that. So let's try the baler out itself. We want to lower the pickup and then we will turn it on. So that one drops down, that's looking good. It's got, ooh, it's got some nice animations on the machine. Wrap bales is on. Well, I want to turn the wrap bales to off. There. Excuse me. Okay, so we will leave the bales wrapped off. Set the bale, the size of it, 1.3, 0.4, 5. Ah, I see. Right, well, what size bale should we set? Let's set the middle. We'll go for 1.4. We'll set that in the middle. Change drop mode, auto. Right, well, we'll leave that on auto. And let's go. I can turn that one off a minute. Let's see if this... Okay, he is struggling. And he hadn't even done anything yet. So he might not even be able to do... Oh, no. I don't... Oh, we can't even get up the hill. Oh, that's terrible. This tractor won't even run it. Right, let me turn the baler off a second. Pick that up. Right, this tractor won't run this baler. At least not whilst going up a hill. This tractor just isn't quite enough to run the... Oh, that's terrible. I really want to use it. You know, I tell you what, I think the time has come to test drive a tractor. That's what we're going to do. Let's just drive this down to the bottom, and then we'll have a look at the tractors, and we'll see which one we're going to rent one, and we'll use that as a test drive for a new tractor, because I did say before that I thought we should get a new tractor. So this is the ideal opportunity. Let me just move over here. If I park this baler down over here, I want one that is going to be able to cope with it. I want a tractor, so I'll put the baler right there. We will off-hitch in a sec, so let's just take a quick look at the tractors. We got our standard tractors, and at the moment we're running about 250 horsepower on our Lamborghini. This Lamborghini is 220, so we could go for a Deutz, a Case Magnum. That is 298,000 if we were to buy it, and that tractor there, that's actually the biggest non-articulated tractor that you can buy. So I mean, maybe we, that's a four. Those are 400 horsepower tractors. I don't think we need that many. This one might be a good one, or this one here, that's 260. Let's just go back a minute and see what I got over in the mods. I know I've got several old tractors for my other series, my old time series. 257, that's a 400 horsepower tractor. Again, I think that's a little bit too extravagant for a farm such as ours. Let's just quickly scroll through here. There is that one, which is 220. That's an old Russian thing, that is. It is articulate. I don't particularly like it, to be honest. That tractor there is 370 horsepower. It is a nice tractor, though. It's also one of the most expensive ones I've got on here. What's that other John Deere? That's a smaller one. Or I've got this Fendt here. That's 500 horsepower. I don't think I need that. At 90,000 pounds, I should say. 400, 250, right. I don't think we're going to get a modded one. Oops. I will, I'm going to have to make the decision on my way up. I got to unhitch this baler a minute. There we go. The baler can stay there. This tractor can now go back to the farm. He can at least be used for pulling the trailer when we come to pick up all the bales. So, you know, he still does have his uses. He is a good tractor. It's not really his fault that we're not able to use it today. So I'll take this back to the farm, and then I will hire another tractor, and we can use that as a test. Right, I don't actually have to check the traffic now because we got it switched off, which does make a bit of a difference. Yes, so we will get another tractor and we'll use that as a test tractor so that we can see which one that we want to buy next. Because like I said, I think we are going to need something a little bit bigger than the Lamborghini to really fit in with some of the machinery that we're now buying. Right, I have decided on the Deutz tractor. It is slightly more powerful than the Lamborghini that we got going. And nice layout on the inside. It's actually pretty good. I like the look of this one. But anyway, hopefully, it's 263 horsepower, this one is. It's the Deutz, what's the number? 7250, is it? Yeah, I can see, 7250 TTV, and I hired a front weight to go with it for the day as well. So we'll see what this one is like, and we might even decide to purchase this one later on. So, let's try again. We want to turn the baler on, and we want to lower the pickup, and we're away. So I'm just going to try and drive this sideways on a little bit to start with, so that we can sort of see what it's like. And going by the speed of it, I think it should actually be able to go a fair bit faster than this. So I'm guessing that really we want something in the 300 horsepower range. So maybe we're going to go for one of those Case Magnums. Now, this is the bit. Once the bale goes through the first bit, it then you start filling the compression chamber. It'll drop the bale down behind us, and I am sort of running this sideways on, so I can't see it perfectly. It drops the bale. It moves the bale from the first bit into the second bit, I think. Hang on, no, it's going to put it on there. Is it going to roll it down the hill now, straight downhill into the road, or is it going to stay there? Oh, it's actually going to stay. So the tractor moves along and it fills up the bale chamber. Once the bale is actually complete, when it reaches 100%, the bale is then wrapped with net. But while it's being wrapped with net, the tractor slows down because all the straw going in the front goes into the pre-compression chamber, which basically squashes it down tight for the center of the next bale. And by doing that, there we go, look, now it's wrapping the bale with net, and then it pushes the bale out and it moves the straw from the compression chamber into the pre-press chamber, it's called on here. It's sort of, basically that's how it works. And and then it wraps it up. So let's go along behind and see what it looks like from back here. This thing does look pretty cool. And there we go, it's now putting net round the bale, Then it moves it back here, and obviously if we were putting wrap on the bales, it would start wrapping it then before it lowered it down onto the ground. And I am just going to actually, we'll stop a second and bring up the help. Now we'll set the bale size a fraction bigger and see if it does any difference. Hang on, we'll go with 1.4 a minute, and I'll move up through and we'll see how big it makes the bale. So exactly 4,000 to make the bale. So it'll wrap it and then it'll move it out, and then the straw will start moving into the next one, and it's already mostly full anyway. Okay, so now I will change the bale. I don't want to wrap the bale. I want to set the bale width. Now it's 1.5 to the bale width. So let's just see if that actually makes a bigger bale or not. I don't think it will. I think the bale will actually come out the same. It might just look slightly larger in appearance. But I'm not quite certain. Find out in a minute. Okay, and move up. Right, still 4,000, so that's the same. It might come out with a slightly bigger bale, that's all. I'm going to stop here a second. It does actually move everything from the pre-press chamber into the bale, so we're not losing straw as we go along. Those bales look similar. That one's moving. I wonder if it's actually going to stop, or if it's going to roll all the way down the field. Okay, I'm going to remove that a minute. And got to come around this corner a little bit tighter than I would normally like to. That's okay. We've got a double joint PTO shaft on there, so it should be okay. I'm just going to go behind because I want to see the bale again. Excuse me. It's changed. Now that we've gone, it's now 5,000 on the bale instead of 4,000. So we're actually getting more per bale. Which is actually quite impressive, because it went 4,000. I guess because we changed it in the middle, it made a difference to it. So we can have fewer bales off the field, and hopefully the game will actually remember which bales are which. I do hope so, because that's 5,000 per bale there. But I think that is actually going to be better for us, having 5,000 per bale instead of 4, because fewer bales to pick up means that we get the job done that much quicker. So let me come up through here and gather this bit up. Let's try this in cab a minute and see what it's like in cab. So I've just got that little bit, and I'm going to turn round, and we've got a bit up there. I'm just going to cut across the windrow. There we go. Right, that's full. And I've got some little patches back there. I'm not too concerned about missing that. I just want to get this here. Now, you do have to be careful, because obviously if we reverse whilst we're towing this baler, we might back into a bale, and that could spell complete and utter disaster for us, because it'll dent up the machine. We really, really don't want to do that. This is an expensive machine, and it's ours. It's not like it's a rented tractor or something where we could just send it back. Of course, we would never dream of doing that. Now, would we? Right, let me see if I can just grab these. This straw texture pack, I don't know if it's this game or if it's just the one that I've got on coming through. I think it's this map. Except this game, didn't I? Yeah, I think it's this map, this straw texture pack. It makes the straw look bulkier than it is. It makes it look like you've got more here than there actually is. We are still very, very slow on this hill. Is it going to let us go? No. So we can't get up this hill even with this baler, this tractor. I could try getting a bit of a run-up, I guess. Let's try that. Is it going to let me go? It's not having it at all, is it? Okay. Okay, this baler is obviously really, really heavy. These tractors will not go with up this hill. So we're going to need a... Oh, crumbs. I forgot about that. Field 6. Is it 6 or 16? Just take a quick peek. Field 16, that is a much bigger field. I think we might have to admit that this is kind of money wasted hiring this tractor, because we're not going to be able to bale up field 16 with this one. If it can't get up that hill, it is not going to be able to bale field 16, which is really, really bad. I didn't want that. Just have a look here. You can sort of see it gathering up there inside. It's kind of on the animation. It's a little bit more difficult to see what you're doing when you're inside the cab. Let's come up through here. Okay, I'm coming out to see this. It is getting there slowly. Ah, I see. So you've got a constant animation stream at the front there. If we go into cab a second, I'll just sort of remember which way we're going. That looks pretty cool, actually, flowing in like that. That's actually kind of realistic for a baler as well. You do get that sort of nice, even, steady stream of straw going in. Okay. I think I left... Yeah, I left a bit behind back there. And there's bits... It's a bit of a mess up this end. We did have some odd bits here and there, so we'll have to maybe swing round a few times to tidy it up, or just admit that we're going to leave bits behind and then cultivate it back in with our direct drill, because that will cultivate it at the same time. So it'll sort of cover it up, and then we can pretend it never really happened. Come round here and grab this. Right, I'm going to bale a little bit more in this field, because I can at least do this field. That is one thing that I could do. I can at least do this field. And once this field is done, we can come through and we can gather up the bales. And then I want to get another tractor, but we can always leave the baling of field 6. I keep forgetting. Field 16. 16. It's definitely 16. We can always leave the baling of field 16 until after we've done our silage. Get the silage, get it in by the biogas plant. And once we start selling that, it will mean then that we'll be able to make a bit of money out of it and hopefully buy a new tractor. So if we're going to be buying an expensive tractor, it'll be one of the case ones, I suspect, and probably the 350 horsepower tractor. I think there's one about 350. That would seem to be about the sensible choice now, because this baler is obviously a lot more than a 250 horsepower tractor can handle, so that is going to make a difference. Right, I will bale a fair bit of this field, and then I will come back to you so that you can have a look at, slightly finished field. Partly finished field, I should say. Okay, I've done a section up the top here. Just sort of doing out this last little triangle. It's coming along quite nicely. We've got a few bales now. We've got 23 altogether so far. And I'm going to carry on and do this field now. Before the next episode, and then once this field is done, field 5 has now been completed. He has completely finished that one, so we'll be ready to go on and seed the next one, which is probably going to be field, probably field 22 will be the next one. We'll move straight up and we can go into that one. We'll be able to use this Deutz tractor at least to start with, and then we can use our John Deere for ferrying the silage back and forth, because it will cope with that all right, I should think. We've got our own forage harvester, and I'm going to buy a new header for the forage harvester so that we can use that to cut the grass direct, so that we don't need to go through with mowers and rakes and everything first. I think it'll be a lot faster, a lot more efficient, and then we'll be able to get that field off and in as quickly as possible. And then we will be buying a new tractor. I'm not sure if we'll be able to buy it next week or if it'll be the week after, but we will buy it as soon as we're able to. Let me just take a quick look in here. I wasn't thinking of getting any of the tractors we got in here. The JCB Fast Track would be nice. That's a 310 horsepower. That might be enough to tow the baler. I'm not quite certain. I would say that we need actually a little bit more juice than that to pull it. The fence, I feel, is a bit too big for this one. And... we've got that case, we've got that one that's 435 horsepower. That is a bit of a monster tractor. Those are 250, so we've got 400 there. What else did we have? We got this John Deere, which is 370. The John Deere is a possibility. Let me move back here, back into here, and we go up through that case there. Oh, that's 430 as well. Right, so we are going to need a big tractor. I didn't think that we would need something this big for this farm, but we got this baler now, so we're going to need something that is going to be able to tow it properly. So really, it's a choice, 250, 320, yeah, that one there would have been way too small. So that's much the same power as a tractor that we got. So it's either got to be this case or this John Deere over here. I might actually go for the John Deere. I might go for that one. Because we haven't used the John Deere. I haven't used the John Deere in any of my series yet, apart from, obviously, the old John Deere that we got here. So maybe it's time to try John Deere. I'm not quite sure, but that is... I'll have a look at that. I might put that up to a vote next week. I'm not quite sure. Remember, this week's vote is which wheel loader do you want me to get? Do you want me to get the Liebherr, which is the game standard one, the new JCB one that came with the DLC, or the new Holland modded one, which is actually from... that might actually be from one of the DLCs as well, the free New Holland DLC. But anyway, it's one of those three loaders. Head down below, let me know which one you think would be best. It's your vote, it's your game. But that's all I've got time for today. I will carry on and I will finish this field before the next episode. And then the first thing we're going to be doing, actually, is gathering up all of these bales. And then after that, silage, I think. Yeah, we need to crack on and get that silage done. We will also continue on with some seeding. We'll go up into field 22 and seed that one out. I cannot currently remember what it was that everybody suggested we should put there, so I will consult my notes, because I did ask everybody that one. So, I'll consult and see which one it is, but that will be done next week as well. If you enjoyed this episode, please head down below and give me a like. That would be really cool. And if you particularly enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. Get them to watch it as well. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.